Good morning, walkers. And as you can tell by the big red bus and the British flag on the Holiday Inn Express across the street, we are in London. This morning, we are starting off at the Holiday Inn Express because, one, that's where we're staying, Holiday Inn Express, London City. We're not sponsored or anything, but I just wanted to point those out. We like to stay at them in London the last few times we've been here because, one, it's really affordable, especially when you add in the free breakfast, which, unlike the free breakfasts at discount hotels in the States, they're not prepackaged, plastic-ridden, sugar-filled breakfasts. They are actual food. It's sausage and eggs and beans and yogurt and granola and fruit and toasts and stuff, coffee, etc. And we just get a lot of value out of that, especially when we're on tour and we travel with our kids. So getting some decent food into them gives them enough energy to do a full day, which is really important and makes life easier for everybody. Before I get into the London walk, I just want to comment on how many bicyclists there are here. It's absolutely great. Thousands of them I've seen so far this morning, the last 10 minutes. It's in the middle of the commute. It's about 8:15, 8:20. And we are going to head down to the Tower of London and Tower Bridge this morning. It's probably about 60 degrees out, early September. Absolutely beautiful day. Give us a like if you like these videos. Give us a comment if you don't mind. We love hearing back, feedback. One of the things of feedback I'd like to find out, sorry for the noise, is what's the optimal length for these? You as a viewer, do you think they're a little too long? Would you like them to be, say, 20 minutes, 30 minutes? I've been trying to do 40 minutes to a little bit over an hour with, you know, limited success. But I'd really like to know, how long I should be making them. If you do like them, please subscribe and click that bell notification button up there. And you'll get notified when I post new videos. What else? I really don't know much about London. I've been here a couple times, but not nearly enough for to say I know really anything about the city. I know where some of the major landmarks are. We did a tour of the Tower of London yesterday, which was great. We had minimal crowds, which is always nice. And we did a little, they do a free walking tour around with the yeoman. And that was a lot of fun, especially for the kids. And hopefully I don't get run over here. Take my reading glasses off. We are walking down the Great Eastern Street towards the Thames right now, which I think means we're headed south. One of the things I've noticed about London last 2 days is, one, I'd never want to drive here. It's absolutely crazy. But people are super polite. Somebody did a U-turn in the middle of the road. and other cars stopped and let him do it and didn't even honk at him. This is, I think, more honking of horns than I've heard all day yesterday. Very polite. Love all the bikes. We're getting into the downtown area of steel and glass. It's one of the things I actually do like about modern architecture here in London. It's all really pretty innovative and beautiful stuff. It's not just concrete and narrow windows. You can see the see all the cyclists. Well, not all of them, but a lot. Passing 175 Bishop Gate. Love this building. I believe it might be called the Gherkin. Yeah. Costa is the UK coffee chain. Going on to Lime Street. I'm gonna cut down here. Between the buildings, you can see something called the walky-talky building, I think, locally. Anybody that wants to, that is local, knows London, please feel free to correct me or better inform me or add some timestamps in your comments to places that I'm not calling out that are interesting. That's always helpful and appreciated. truck left here. Onto Fenchurch Avenue. Fenchurch. Think. On the left is Munster Court. I don't know if that's significant, but you can find it on Google. Apologize for any wind noise. The Osmo Pocket is not great for audio, and I don't have a separate audio recorder with me. Right through that gap, you can see a building called the Shard. And down this way, you can start to see a bit of the Tower of London. And we're up on what's called Tower Hill, I believe.
he was really going for it.
Love these special bike lanes. This church is, I guess, All Hallows by the Tower, founded in 675 AD. Apparently the oldest church in the city. See the tower and Tower Bridge. It's loud. How the hell are you here? That round building with the glare on it is City Hall, I believe, or part of it. Okay, here we go, the Tower of London, one of our first major stops. We went in here yesterday, as I said earlier. It is really cool, a lot of great history. A ton to see in there. There's the crown jewels, of course. There's also the white keep, or the white castle, something like that. I can't remember which one it's called, but it's in the center. It's the oldest part. It has this really cool display of armaments and historical display of those armaments. This place was a mint for a while. Of course, there's some great in quotes execution history and escape history and military history, and you can learn a lot. There's several different types of tours you can take that are free, which is good because it costs an extortionate amount to get in. I believe it opens around 10 o'clock every morning, 9 during the week, except for Monday, which is 10, and it closes by 5:30. It's for a family price of four is £77. With one adult, it's 54. That's with a suggested donation, and I'm a bit cheap at those prices, so I told them not to add that on, which took it down to £50 for one adult and two kids. You can also buy tickets online ahead of time. It does get really, really crowded. And so I suggest going early or late, probably early because you have more time if you can swing it. It's really not much of a tower compared to modern day standards. But I guess back in the day, it was. And who knows, maybe tower had a different meaning back then? I don't know. Somebody knows, I guess. The tour we took, the guide was the Raven Keeper, and he actually had one of the ravens that came up, flew up to him, and cawed at him several times and demanded food, which he gave it. His name George, and the keeper's written a book and been on a TV show called, I think, Inside the Tower, maybe? The tour was definitely worth the time. Lots of great information. And the boys loved it. A couple of beef eaters now. They have to be retired military in good standing, having done a full tour, I guess, 22 years, I think. And many of them live in the tower. There, of course, is Tower Bridge, which we'll be heading across.
He's never gonna be here.
First, I want to go over and show you the River Thames. That old destroyer battleship looking boat is the HMS Belfast, and behind that is the Shard that I mentioned earlier. I think it might be the tallest building in London, but you might want to fact check that, I guess. That's what I'm saying. Beautiful, beautiful city. You can actually go up into that upper section of the Tower Bridge, and there's some glass-bottomed walkways. Of course, it costs money. Oh, we got some beef eaters and guards coming up here. Love that stuff. That's not just a show for the tourists either. It's actually I believe it's a military installation. This is the Trader's Gate, or Water Gate, right over here. You can see that the water showing some shoreline here, that the Thames is affected by tides. The White Keep. Sorry for the bumps, it's hard to walk on this cobble without doing that. Don't worry, we're still gonna cross the Tower Bridge. I just wanna get a better look at it from this side with the light. Across the river is Butler's Wharf, which looks like a development, condo, something like that.
Was ist? Wo man hat jetzt? Now with power.
There's the downtown and the tower. Looks like two adults and two children to go up into the tower is 22 pounds. I think an adult is 10 pounds. Old and the new. All right, everybody, I think that's gonna do it for today. It's right around 51 minutes. Thank you for joining us once again. Hope you enjoyed this walk through London. There's some other walkers around London that you might enjoy. London Walks, City Walkers, I think Pro Walks does some here, and some others that I'm missing, but I'll try and find their channels and link below. So check them out and support them as well. This really is a gorgeous, historic, fascinating city. Love the diversity, love the architecture, love the history. So great. Give us a like, give us a thumbs up, give us a comment, subscribe, click the bell, all that fun stuff. Share with your friends. Most of all, get out there, have a great walk, and join us next time. We'll see you soon.